are broadcasting live from the Thunderdome in Cinerapolis, Forskin, Minnesota. And the Mutant Eaters have a proud history in the MFL of winning just about everything but the really big game that matters.
Maybe that's why they have the same exact number of bars and churches.
Hey, shut up and pass the tater tots, huh?
Today's matchup promises severed limbs and ruined careers. Lots of beers. The new Yuck threats take on the Purple Mutant Eaters. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's time to turn on, tune in, and get your mutant buzz on. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow here. It's MFL Game Day, and you know what that means.
Yeah, the town will be in flames tonight, and half the city's population will be sliding down greased street poles and eating all-you-can-eat horseshit buffets from the curb.
Yes, victory can be bittersweet sometimes, Bricks. Let's see if the home team can light up this town like a Roman candle. And it's first and ten.
And whoever said never hit a man when he's down is just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
You get my grill, I'll ruin your world. Ruin it.
And it's first and ten. That's a four-yard gain. Second down and six. First down. Give this guy... come on, that was a cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. And so do the fans. And it's first and ten. It's about a 3-yard pickup. Second down and seven. Oh, the defender almost picked off the ball on that one. And that'll bring up third down and seven. If you don't think you can make the interception, batting it down is the next best thing.
Great advice, Grim. That receiver's gonna go far in this league if he listens to you.
I wasn't talking to... never mind. Yes, Brick, he will. A misfired punt will give the opposing team... They just let that one drop and play it safe, and the defense says, we'll take it. And it's first and ten. There aren't too many players that kids can look up to at home. He took a leap and had the ball knocked out. Fumble!
He's got a case of fumbleitis! Goal!
If you ever do that again, Bricks, I'll shoot you in the head.
But people like it!
Hey, okay.
Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It's good. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't abroad in my bed. It was a chip wearing a wig.
And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to fight it.
Oh, Lance is getting kills.
This is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. Nice pass. That catch is good for 6 yards. Third down and 8. Hey, kids, do you remember getting shoved in a locker because you wore... And the back gets in there and swats the ball away.
He can't catch, but he sure can swat.
Oh, boy, they're going for it. This could get uglier than the baby result.
They go to win. The MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8. The greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Where?
Man, those bones can boogie.
The lack of muscle.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
He refuses to go down! Monkey trying to fuck a greased football, he gets away in a hurry. And it's first and 10. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him.
Hey, man, nobody can touch him when I ball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, Pop?
And it's first and 10. And that's perfect coverage. Nice deflection. Second down and 10. Quarterback passes for a touchdown. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters.
Straight through the uprights. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And it's first and 10. Man, wow! You knew you were going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. it's first and 10. It's 2 yard run before he stopped. And that'll be second and 8 to go. And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
Four more downs to punish the defense, and you better believe they will. And it's first and 10. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 on that play. It's anyone's game still at this point.
I know, which makes it so hard to place a bet.
Second down and 5. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
Now, still working on my salami here, Bricks. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. And it's first and 10. Oh, and that's how you play defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick. Second down and 10. Pull that about a 6 yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night locked up for solicitation.
Third and 4. Done for a first down. And it's first and 10. The defense has the receivers covered well. That's a 3 yard gain on that pass. Second down and 7. And the defense spiked the offensive water with Strawberry Fields. And now they can punch his way out of that tackle. Third down and 8. Cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. And this werewolf is from London, I believe, signed in the offseason.
Yeah, I saw him at Trader Dick's hotel party the other night. His hair was perfect.
Better watch out. He'll rip your lungs out, Bricks. And here comes the extra point attempt. Goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's first and ten. The quarterback passes the ball and it rebounds back.
He can't get rid of it. It's like me and these crabs, Grim.
And the defense calls a sticky ball dirty trick and the QB is in a heap of trouble now. Second down and a lot. You gotta love a player who goes down fighting. They're gaining on him.
Hey, come on, move your ass. I got a sawbuck right on this asshole.
Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass. That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. Second down, and the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Second down in a mile. And they needed that big run right there, Bricks.
They sure fucking did, Grim. They sure fucking did.
Third down and never gonna happen. Kinda reminds me of that painting of dad carving the turkey. Grim. The 20, the 10, he scores! He earned those points on the heels of an epic run.
Don't call things epic, Grim. Kids aren't gonna think you're cool no matter what you do.
Junior, I don't want kids to think I'm cool.
I am a hell no fella.
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It's good. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
First and ten. They've called a zap attack. The ball carrier. Oh, he was hitting mid-hurdle and fumbles the ball. Oh, he's basically an electric chair right now with legs and pads. And anything he touches gets fried. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. And they line up for the extra point. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Bricks. It means he can return it for... You know what? Never mind. It's first and 10. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. Second down and 9. Either the defense is trying to keep some time on the clock for their offense, or someone let a real bonehead touch the controller. Third down and long. He's not going down. He's leaving it all out on the field today. And there's his large intestines over there, his liver.
I think his spleen is stuck on that guy's cleat.
No, that's a gallbladder.
Oh, my bad.
Another running back and only two remain on their roster. When a team loses all their running backs, they lose their ability to run the ball.
Yeah, like if I rip out your tongue, you won't be able to speak. Tell us something we don't know, genius.
And it's first and 10. I hope you covered your ears, Bridgman, because then... Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. Boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a 2-minute drill. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Well, he won't be waking up anytime soon.
And if he does...
The ref that just called that penalty, he was convicted of marrying old ladies and stealing their savings.
That sounds like a good job.
He's right at home here, taking money from coaches, players, and fans.
I even saw him swiping money from the bathroom attendant.
Yeah, who don't do that?
And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. The defender cut off that pass like a suburban mom on the way to speak to the manager. And he sure got his refund. He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? Oh, the unstoppable force meets the explodable object. The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where are we going, Grim? A carnival? Huh? Gonna go to a striptease show? Where are we going?
Hey, why don't you settle down? Just pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die.
big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
And it's first and ten. Looks like a pass, and it's bouncing right back to the kid, and he just popped his eyes in the back of his head. That quarterback could be hurting, or dead, or worse. Second down and long. He picks up 10 yards on that play. Third down and six. And they call it the runner pulls out a kick. Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Now, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed everyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but, you know, not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Man, I've had it. I'm running out of excuses.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
And it's first and ten. One speed, engage, he finds open space, he's running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch. See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see it.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. And it's first and ten. Second down in a very lot. Tackles. He takes a lick and a kick, and the quarterback finds his man for the first down. And it's first and ten. That's a catch for a 10-yard gain. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. Third
down and five. A brutal head-on collision. Not only does he drop the ball, but someone's going to be taking a long nap after that hit. And this field goal is certainly within the kicker's range. It's good. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. The kicker just ended up in the meat wagon. They'll need to find another player on their bench who can kick field goals. Good luck with that. The burn returner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. And it's first and 10. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life.
There's a bloody red head on the field.
No, that's their red penalty marker, Briggs. Looks like this one's coming back. The offense is down to their last running back. No rest for the weary. The last runner has to suck it up and hopefully not die. And it's first and 10. At this rate, the QB's gonna hit. Oh, that'll trim your nostril hairs once and for all. They might catch him.
Oh, you fat little mutant.
He's at the 10.
Holy mother of mutant mayhem, he scored!
Say what? Come on, man, you can't hang with me. You get my grill, I'm gonna ruin your world. You understand me?
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. It's a pass and catch for no gain.
Then how is it a pass?
Third down and the punter is warming up. And this guy looks like Thor on a revenge bender right now. With the zap attack. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can see that, man.
Lost their last running back on the previous play. Next time the offense comes out on the field, they will have no running plays. And they line up for the extra point. Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10. And he stayed with the receiver and deflected the ball. Second down and 10. The roid rage dirty trick transforms a player into a rampaging lunatic for the duration of the play. I know that's typical of all MFL players, but this is different. Trust me, very different. And the MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8, the greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Where?
It's first and 10. And the defense calls a Strawberry Fields dirty trick. You know, this takes me back to those crazy days of my youth, Bricks. Good times. Married a little Swedish midget, lived in a sweat lodge for about a year. Well, at least, I think that's what I did. Second down and a lot. That's a gain of 7 yards on the catch. Nicely done. Third and 4. And that brings us to the end of the third quarter. They'll need to fire on all cylinders to make a comeback in the final quarter. Third and 4. With multiple interceptions, the QB should just throw in the towel.
Yeah, he'd probably have it intercepted, though.
He could go all the way! He's at the 40. He's at the 30. The 20. He's running out of gas now. And that's a pick six for the defense and a possible electrocution for the quarterback.
Nobody can touch you when I'm on. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
And here comes the extra point attempt. It's good. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Quinn? Aren't we all?
Oh, and that's how you play defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
Needs a miracle. Caught for the first down. And it's first and 10. Boom to the moon. Another loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry up.
Same as Bricks' ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it rabbits.
And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. And it's first and 10. Defense gets another pick. Man.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not your own.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
Ha, And it's first and 10. He broke free and has open field in front of him. And it's first and 10. And that's another turnover for the defense. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy. Does anyone have a rule book? Because that sounds like he's making stuff up.
Do we have a rule book?
It's propping up your chair so you can reach the table without spilling your food, idiot.
First down and inches. It's a jailbreak, and the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Ho-ho! Crowd's loving it. And it's first and 10. Looks like we've got a penalty here. First down and one. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. He's at the 40. They might catch him.
Move, you fat little mutant.
The 10. And he runs into the end zone for a touchdown. Two quarterbacks remaining on the roster. They better be careful because when those guys die, it's forfeit city. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And it's first and 10. Oh, no, that was totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome! I hope they have raincoats in the front row, because that was splattering everywhere!
Second down and more than the QB would like.
Hot one, hot two, hot...
Defense gave up a lot of yards on that pass play. They'll need to re- Oh, you knew you were going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. And it's first and 10.
Hot. Hot one.
Rumbling and stumbling, he could go all the way. Oh man, Bricks, you gotta love a player who goes down fighting. And it's first and 10. Huh? stuck to him like glue. Second down and 10. And he's running like a moose right. Boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger, because he's going to kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message, because the messenger killed him. Ah, going in circles.
It shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. Straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
Goes into the hurry-up formation to try to conserve time. I don't know whose eyes the QB is using, but can we get him some new ones?
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
First and 10.
Hot one.
Oh, the defender almost picked off the ball on that one. Second down and 10.
Hot one. Hot two.
Cornerback is down.
Zoom in on his face. I want to see if the little bastard's crying.
The defense calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have two left. Third down and, well, good luck.
Hot one.
Two linemen. Once they're gone, it's game over.
Yeah, who cares? Linemen suck. They don't even deliver any fantasy points. They spend 2 years in the league and then they become bouncers at biker bars.
And the defense uses their second timeout to stop the clock to preserve time for their offense. First down and one.
Hot one. Hot two.
Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
He's at the 40. The 30. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey. The offense lost their final quarterback. Lucky for them, they're on defense now, or the game would be over.
So all the other team has to do is punt to force a forfeit?
That would be correct, Bricks. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just...
And the Purple Mutant Eaters decimate the competition today and deliver their home team fans a forfeit.
Grim, some of the defensive Mutant Eater players are snacking on the left of the body parts.
Why do you think they're called the Purple Mutant Eaters, you idiot?
They come up big today with a solid win, and the opposition will be licking their wounds on the long plane ride home.
I heard wounds taste... just like chicken. Or was it scrambles tomato soup? I forget, but a good scab tastes like bacon. Damn, I know.
A scab lettuce tomato sandwich. Sounds like a picnic. And the MVP is about to inspire us with some words of wisdom.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it, so...